This is a white heron that I'm going to paint for a fellow superintendent. He sent me a picture where he took it on the lake. It's a 16 by 20 canvas, and I got an acrylic modeling paste on it. I've got the plants all on it, probably a willow, I'm not sure. But anyway, I've got the pole, like I say, and everything. It's all carved up and in. I got to put the feet on. And we're going to do that now. I'm going to use a modeling knife, a palette knife. It's narrow, get some detail in. I'll use a brush, I'll wet it. I've got the model paste here, a little bit of water. And I'll use a flat foam plate where I can work it back and forth as I need it to get my shape into my picture. So we're going to start on that now. Okay, what we're going to do first, I've already got my modeling paste on here. I'm going to go ahead and start putting the feet in. You got to remember, you're working with your foreground first and work towards your background. So I'm going to start in on his feet. I got to bring it down just a little bit more. You got to remember, when it dries different than what you're actually putting on. So however you put it on, you got to kind of keep in mind that you got to kind of see how things are going to change, kind of know how it goes. It looks totally different once it cures out, kind of gives it the 3D. So you want it, it's got to be right, because when you paint it, it's going to kind of shadow and move with the painting. Kind of get the idea. Once this dries, when I get all this done, I'll just dry out for a few days and I'll come back. And then I'll start painting it. Of course, the bird has joints in his feet, so we have to make sure those go in. It gets a little easier to work with too as you go, because it starts thickening up. Joint here, his feet started. You gotta get the angles just right. Make sure I want to go more straight. Shake it out. I gotta get his claws in there too. When this dries, you got to get your height on it, because you want it to stick out a little bit. And let me put his claw in. His claw, actually. Hang it up. Just a little. Make sure a claw gets in there. It's got like a claw that goes upward and back down. Right now. It's hard to tell. Once it sets up, gives that shape. Let's see. Yeah, I'm around these birds a lot, around Saddle Creek and everything, so pretty well know what they look like. Sure, the legs are pretty good. They're pretty stout right in here in this joint. They're skewed, so we gotta make sure those are correct. Get enough shape in here, I'll take my brush and dance it out a little bit. Make it a little better. I'm going to carry his feet all the way out to the edge of the post. Not balancing himself, so I'm going to do it to this right. Then he gets narrower as he goes. Be careful too, because whatever you've already got in there, if you touch it, if you bump it, it'll mess it up once you get a shape in there on it. So you gotta watch it too. I'm not shaping any feet here. I got 1, 2, 3 joints. Joint number 3. Yeah. Alright, there's one. Alright, I'll shape it in here a minute when I get more of it in. I used to kind of cheat and use a cake icing, one of those little bags, and I make with the little tips on it where you put all the fancy colors and everything on it, and make flowers and all that good stuff. And it was easier, you could squeeze it out and get it done, but I don't know, I just think they're pretty humorous. Sure this actually rounds in to the feet. Alright, and I'll shake it in a minute. That one claw is actually sticking up in the air. There we go. He's had the back part of his feet. You can't really see much, but it counts. It actually goes that way. Let me shift that in the brush. Alright. Doesn't look like much right now. Soften myself a brush. Gotta keep a little, not too wet, a little bit. Alright. This will kind of smooth it out. And as I wait and let it get a little bit thicker, just go to let me texturing it out after that. Okay, I don't want to get too much in the wood because I've got to have my wear and tear of my wood shape there. Let's get a shape. This goes into a B. There's not much of a claw. I'm not sure we get the claw in there. It's hard to tell, but I mean, you're dealing with a shape. And you gotta kind of think how it's going to look. And the other leg comes forward. And that one, so you gotta keep that forward. And go into his joints. Listen to it later. Would it work? Doesn't have to be perfect. I mean, if you want perfect to me, you take a picture. I'm not looking for perfection. Just want to let it represent what it is. Flatten out a little bit. There's just actually a lot of that here. And 2, 3 joints and claw. Alright. Claw. That's already good to me. I'll look at flatten out a little bit. There we go. And I got one spot here I don't like. It's gotta go. We don't need a second spot sticking in. Alright. Alright, there's one. What I like is the back one. Make sure we clean up underneath it. And make that wood stand out, got that shape in there. Because it will show through. And it won't look right if you don't do it right. There we go. The back one I can go ahead and just do. To the back. And it comes to a point. All right. And there we go. When they dry it, I draw in. claws will show, and I'm not sure quite, although I would like to see this right in here a little thicker because it's kind of putting pressure on his feet right here. That joint. That'll work. That'll be his feet, his claws. First foot number one. There you go. Okay, first foot number one. Alright, now we're going to move to the second foot. So, I got to get that joint right. It's got to come down and taper. Get enough there to work with. Like I say, if you get too much, not a big deal, because you can always go in with a brush and shape it, but what you got to watch when you're overlapping on the other wood, after you already got the shape, you'll actually fill it, so you might want to take a brush and wet it lightly and kind of dance it around and make it thin out, and then when it dries, it doesn't show up, it actually looks correct. That's what I like about Florida, a lot of wildlife, a lot of diversity. My whole life down here, I've been around it. A lot of wildlife. I've always been out messing around the canals and fishing and everything since I've been a little. I was 11 years old to come down here. Right now, we gotta get this foot just right because it's going forward. Just right. I'm gonna shake it up in there. And it's actually running. It's going up over the other foot. And he'll need that claw. It's running past his leg. So we'll have to indicate that claw's on the other side. This is a little thin right now. I prefer it a little thicker, but hey, you know, it'll work it out. Starting on this back foot. Put the back foot in there. Kind of angles up short. Okay. Yeah, I was a teacher's aide at Auburndale High School for 3 years. I taught a lot of kids how to draw and how to paint and this and that. Used to enjoy it a lot. Long time ago. Just getting it on there. I just want to get it filled. I'm going to go back and touch it. Of course, this is wider. His joint, his ankle. Make sure his pressure points look right. Fill that a little bit. Have to work with it. That one doesn't show a lot of joints on it. Alright, but the back one does, and it actually comes up. And up. Curve on that. Alright. And then the side leg actually comes off the fall. Just a little bit. too heavy in there. Because I don't want it to appear it's in the foreground. Now, the curious foot, which actually angles off the pole. It's just a little sharper, but that'll work. I'm okay with that. Mm-hmm. Actually, let's do this. Let's take it. You can move it. You can move it around a little bit. Let's go ahead and take the taper down. It's actually going to work out just right. The shape's already about there. And chicks flying over. So just be aware of where all your edges and your canvas. Just like I'm raking this, every time you rake it, if you're careful, you can actually see it in it. That'll work. Do now. Got my brush a little bit damp. Taking a little water here and there, pressing it. You want to get it wet now. Just run. Just barely want that brush wet. Right. Building up his leg. Up to the other leg. Making sure the wood texture stays in. It's got a nice little curve right here. Down. Got a claw going out there. Put that in. And straighten this out. We'll paint that claw in it so it won't look like that. I'm putting the claw in now. one, all that little extra comes out. And then I put in the pole textures. I don't want that to look like it's in front of it, so I'm gonna carry it on over. Actually, I'm gonna carry that down just a hair. It's on top of the pole. Or look right. If you don't, it won't look right. It's totally right. This claw's not up and standing. There's some fireworks going off. It's been a pretty good 4th of July. It's 4th of July weekend. 4th of July weekend, sorry. I'm so focused on this. It's New Year's weekend. Not thinking, focusing too much. Alright. Make sure this one's behind that one. Let's take this one up and mark that one down. There we go. I gotta keep in mind, it's not gonna look the same when it dries, so you gotta keep that thought in your head the whole time. Putting that one claw out there, building on that. It sits up like it, alright? The paint's what will bring out the detail. You can get this all done. The paint itself, when you put in the shadowing, the colors, that'll bring it on out. So. Alright, next thing will be the painting when this sits up for a couple of days.
Okay, there's the feet all put in. We'll take another picture of it on the next round and show you how it draws in.